Last week, I was trying some UV portrait photography for the first time using only a small UV light. If you haven't seen that video yet, make sure you click on this card here or find the link in the description. Hi everyone, it's Ola Dominuko here, and today we'll be editing my UV portraits. It was my first time doing this type of photography. I have never ever done any UV at all, actually not any photography, but any UV stuff at all. So I went on Amazon and I got those tiny paints, tiny paint tubes, and I just like put this all over my face and went creative with it. But because I had no idea what settings I should use, I think most of my pictures, they turned out to be underexposed. They are pretty black. And if you go on Google and type UV portrait, they have pretty purple haze, violet, like ultraviolet. But my pictures, because they were pretty dark, you only could see the paint. And it's okay, I actually liked it very much. I thought it was pretty creative and different. So when I was editing them, I made sure I darkened even more the black, the dark areas, and took the adjustment brush. And I went over every single paint part, so it was standing out more. I created this high contrast in it. So let's go over my computer and I will show you how I did it. And I will take you step by step through my editing process. Alright, so I am in my Lightroom now. And these are the images that I took during my UV portrait session. So they are already edited, but I am still gonna go to develop tab and show you step by step how I did what I did. So this is already reset, and I know that when I was editing this image, it was in the portrait mode, so I am going to crop my image into a portrait mode. I'm going just to do a rough job just to let Lightroom know that I want a portrait. So now I'm gonna go to custom and change one of the sizes they give me. I usually go for 4x5 or 4x6. In this case, I will choose 4x6. I'm gonna press and hold shift, and so this way the ratio of the portrait doesn't change, and just frame it the way I want to, and I think that's looking good. I'm gonna click on done, and now I can play with the exposure. I'm gonna increase it a little bit, and I'm going to add some contrast, increase highlights, texture, clarity slightly, and vibrance. Okay, I don't really like this purple haze on my face, so I'm going to get the adjustment brush, click on the effects twice, so this way everything is going to reset, all the settings are going to reset, my brush is going to be clean. So I clicked on effects twice, and now I am going to decrease blacks. So now I am going to paint over the face. It's going to make the brush bigger and paint over the face. Okay, so now I am going to clear my brush by clicking on effects twice. I'm going to click on new brush and then on effects twice. I'm going to increase exposure a little bit, contrast, texture, clarity, saturation, and I'm going to make my brush smaller. Too small. And go closer, and I am going to start making local adjustments, which means I am going to start painting over the paint, and I am not using a mouse, I am using my graphic tablet. I am not sure if I'm gonna pronounce it properly. I'm using Wacom, and I really like it actually. It's one of the cheaper Wacom tablets, but I really like it. If you want, I'm gonna include the link for this specific tablet that I'm using, and you can check it out yourself. Okay, so I am going to speed up this process and I will see you in a bit. Okay, and now I would like to make sure that my background is completely black, like there's no data in it, just pure blackness. So to do so, I'm going to click on this triangle here and it's going to show me in blue whatever is very, very black, the blackest, the darkest ever. So I'm gonna click on this and then I'm going to get my adjustment brush, click on new, click clear my effects and decrease exposure and blacks. And now I'm going to paint over here. So now you can see that it's the background is very black and that's what I want. Okay, I'm going to click on done. And I guess that this picture is done. So let's go to another one. Okay, this one. I'm gonna reset everything. And this is exactly how I took it. So you can see, obviously, it's very, very dark. So I'm going to do a rough portrait again, choose my size and crop my image. And that's it. I'm going to increase exposure, highlight, contrast, and vibrance. Then with my adjustment brush again, I'm going to clear my settings. I'm going to choose exposure, contrast, texture, clarity, saturation, and I'm going to again paint on my makeup because I want it to glow so much. Okay, and now I'm going to do the same but with the blacks. Okay. New effects twice, and I'm going to decrease exposure and blacks. Clip my darks and let's see. See the before and after? So that's how I was editing my pictures. Let's see some other stuff. How about this one? Or yeah, let's do this one. So I'll have to reset the settings again. My computer is slow, I'm sorry. Oh, this is very underexposed, I don't even remember. Wow, okay. I don't think I was... no, I was cropping it actually. Okay, so let's crop it one more time. Sorry for this, guys. I need to upgrade my equipment. Okay. Right, so again, a rough portrait. Beautiful. And then I'm gonna go and choose my size. Well, it's pretty accurate, wasn't it? And I want it to be roughly here. Okay, now. Wow, look at this. Just increasing highlights is doing so much. Okay, so let's see. A little bit of exposure, a little bit of highlights, contrast, texture, saturation, and I'll have to go and paint over my stuff here. So first of all, I'm gonna increase exposure and texture and just go and paint over the bright stuff here. I think I even went over the eyes as well a bit. And yes, I know that the image is grainy. I took it at ISO 1600. Oh, this one was ISO 400, but for my Canon T6 is a lot, okay? It's actually a lot. This camera doesn't really deal well with low light situation. So whenever I have an opportunity, I will upgrade. Okay, and now let's do new effect and exposure and blacks. And I wanna again go over my background. It's actually pretty dark already. I think it's because I really underexposed my images. Yeah. But next time I will make sure that I will choose the right settings for my pictures. I think I even underexposed them on purpose because I really wanted the paint to glow. So I made it very dark. But also it was hard because I was on my own. I was holding a flashlight in one hand and my smartphone in another hand, and my camera was just recording me. So I was doing everything on my own, like there was nobody to help me really. So I have this little OTG cable that turns my phone into a LCD, so I could see myself and I could focus and stuff. And I'm actually using this now to make this video as well. So I have my Canon Rebel T6 on a tripod in front of me behind my screen. I have I don't really know the name of the light, but it's like a small LED that I bought some time ago. I am actually gonna show it to you here. So that's the one that I am using. And if you are interested, I can post a link. Actually, no, I will post the link in the description so you can check it out yourself. All right. Okay, guys, this is a quick interruption. Please, please, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more videos like this one. So we did this picture. Let's see one of the latest ones. I actually like this one the most. These ones were ones of the last ones where I was having so much fun. I took the paint on my hands and I just like smudged it all over my face. That was amazing, I'm telling you guys. I had so much fun. I had a blast doing this. And if I could, I would highly, highly, highly recommend doing this activity to everyone because it's really amazing. Actually, I have it here. Let me show you. Okay, so that's the flashlight I was using. And it's like a tiny UV light, and I had those paints and they glow basically. But you can even use like pens, and this one is glowing pretty much, and this is just like simple Dollarama pen, and I was using that for my son. I painted some tattoos on his hands and they were glowing nicely in the dark, so he was having fun as well. So yeah, that's it. Okay, let's get back to work. So again, I already edited this one, so let's reset all the settings. All right. Oh, I can actually see, I think there are my books glowing on the shelf. Let's see. Yeah, they are my book glowing. Okay, so I am just going to increase it slightly, and I'm going to crop it again to portrait, and let's go to size. All right, and let's click on done, and let's try highlights. Oh, is that too much? We don't want too much, right? Okay, let's go grab the brush, clear the settings, go with exposure, contrast, texture, clarity, saturation. Now I'm using the mouse, so you probably hear clicking. Okay, I'm going to go and do it here, and the eyes a little bit, and the fingers, and voila, let's click on done. I think I need some more contrast, like just a little bit, and a lot of more vibrance. And now, again, because I can see those bookcases glowing in the back and it's pretty distracting, let's again do the background darkening. So I'm going to get my brush again and I'm gonna go for it. I think I don't even have to deal with the blacks. Oh, I do. Boom, that's what I'm talking about. Okay, that's it. Okay guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Please make sure you like this button. I like this button. You hit this like button and you subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. Thank you. Stay safe.